morning. Thank you for joining me for a workout this morning. Today I'm going to go through a routine that I've been doing for the past couple of years. A couple of years ago I ruptured my L4, L5 and was in excruciating pain for about 8 months until I came up with this routine. And so I've been doing this routine ever since. I do it 2 to 3 times a week during my marathon training days and plan, program, whatever. And when I'm just training with no marathon inside, I do it 5 to 7 times a week. Okay, so just bear with me. I'm just going to go through all the exercises. I'll let you know what it is. But with the exercise, I do use a band. Okay, you can use any type of mini band, anyone that you can find. All right, so we're going to go ahead and get started. All of them are on the ground towards the end. So the first exercise is just a banded pelvic tilt. Okay, so you want to make sure that your heels are close to your glutes. You can touch your fingertips to your heels. And all you're doing is just pulling that pelvis in, core's engaged. I hold for 5 seconds, and I do this for 15 reps. So you can count on your own. Make sure your toes are straight ahead. You want into a bridge with a clamshell. So again, you want to make sure that the pelvis is neutral, the rack is pressed in. I like to bring my hands up here, straight up, hands palms together, and I drive up, and I bring those knees into the band, okay, for a clamshell. 15 reps. Exercise is a frog coming into a bridge. Okay, so same thing. So go into a clamshell first, then drive up, bring those knees in. Okay, clamshell first, drive up. Thank you. distracted pretty quickly. Alright, next one is dead bug. So band it again, still around your knees, low back is resting, arms are up, and it's extending one arm. Opposite arm. I'm usually wearing shorts, so the band does usually stick. So you want to make sure you just adjust it. I do it every 5 reps or so if I am wearing pants. I've tried every type of band there is up there, and they all do the same thing. Neutral is going to want to shift, but you are trying to control engaging the pelvic floor muscles as well as your core. Excellent. The next exercise is a clam shell. Here, you want to make sure your elbow is in line with your shoulder. Your hips are back. I like to be at a little angle here. Heels stay together and your knees come apart. 15 reps here. Again, core is engaged. Keeping everything squared towards the side. Here I go 90-90, so bring my knees 90 degrees. I'm going to kick that top leg back to contract and activate that glute med. And I'm going to drive that knee down and then up. 15 reps. Down to my elbows for a better feel, and I'm going to do a reverse clamshell. So separating the knees, okay, you're activating that glute med, and you're dragging your foot to meet the other foot, and then back up towards the sky, okay? 15 reps here. To a side leg lift. Okay, so top, make sure your hips are squared in front, shoulders are squared. Kick that leg back again to activate that glute med. 15 reps. Foot is flexed. Sides. Okay. Same thing. Clamshell. Engage, activate that glute med. Back to a clamshell, going into reverse clamshell. Separate those knees. Thank you. into all fours. I'll turn this way. Again, make sure that band is right around your knees. Quadra position, so make sure shoulders, elbows, wrists are lined up. Neutral spine. Going into knee circles. We'll be doing 10 going in, 10 going out. Side, going into fire hydrants. This time we're doing 15 reps. And now going into donkey kick. I like to drop the band around my knee to be able to provide a little bit more stability that's going to be working. Okay. 15 reps here. Make sure your foot is flexed. Your heel is towards your glute. Driving that heel up towards the ceiling. Move back to your starting position. To a hip extension. Okay. 20 reps here. Excellent. Now going to the other side. Your donkey kick, 15 reps. And your leg hip extension, okay? Foot flexed, your speed is a little bit quicker. To a standing position. I call this a banded star. I'm already sweating here. San Antonio humidity in the morning. So you'll see that I put the band around my ankle area, lower leg. Okay. So again, you want to make sure your pelvis is neutral, shoulders are back, core is engaged. You're going to take a slight bend in the knee. Very important for runners, right? Because we are in this position for miles at a time. Okay, so slight bend. And I'm going into a star position. So I take it into various positions while maintaining that soft knee bend. And I'm here for 10 repetitions. Although I'm using a band, obviously you don't have to start with the band for any of these exercises. You want to tap down. I cheated right there. Okay. position into a half squat or a squat, going into a standing clamshell. So then shift your weight onto that stance leg, lengthening through that spine to find that balance, and driving that knee out to the side for your clamshell, 15 reps. And now you know my secret to how I stay healthy, how I was able to not get injections for the rest of my life, okay, because that was the recommended therapy and treatment for my L4-L5, because I have other issues with my spine that I was born with. So this is what I do. I do it 2 to 3 times a week right now because I am training for a marathon, but usually I try to do it minimum 5 times a week when I'm just doing training. And it doesn't take long, maybe 10 to 15 minutes once you've got all the exercises down. But it keeps my spine healthy and my core and all my hip muscles that are very important strong. All right, thank you for joining me.